Hello everyone, and welcome back to Xamworth Plays Hand of Fate 2. Last episode we won, and this episode we'll win again, the moon this time. Let's see. You have an insider who may help you infiltrate the palace, gather support amongst the populace of the corruption-seeped city in order to convince them that the emperor must be killed. You have earned an empire death warrant threat lightly. The people of the city are fickle and twisting as the streets they go home. Be prepared to face what may come. So many gambits. Curses. With boroughs being walled off, with the living still inside, citizens will not hesitate to fling curses, even if only just to protect their loved ones. Okay, so we lost Colbion. I didn't like it. Let's take. What are the quest encounters? That's a new one. Filters, token, here we go. I need, I need a lot of food, and I need a lot of food over here. 20 for this one, 10 for Malaclips. Let's take Malaclips and see if we can get further in his quest.
So we need
Headhunt Empire, Curses, Spike 25. That's ridiculous. I think we need to upgrade this one at the blacksmith. Brigand Blade, we need to kill some thieves. Get summon a lost soul. So do I just take a spiked mace and start bashing the Empire soldiers? And then start with more gold. Encounters. Okay, let's see. Filters. Token. We'll take Malaclips. We will need Fairy Ring. Blessed. Cursed. We'll take Fairy Ring. Because we'll go for some curse removal stuff. Are we actually gonna take the Demon Array? Question is, should I go for Purgatory where I can be blessed? It's like the seer, no, the fortune teller, but only for blessings and curses. And then take the demon afterwards to remove the curses. I like that idea. Gotta fight against the is this okay? That's pretty curse heavy. And then companion, merchant's favor. No, we want blessings. Actually, maybe we just go for get as much blessings as possible. So we want food, a lot of food for the. Let's take. I have no idea what to do with the confused one. Let's behead ambush. I'm fine with that. We need food. Maybe some gold. This one can give me food. Yeah. This one could give me food if I win the roll, dice rolls. It's fame. It's fine. Max life equipment. Some equipment gain. Let's see what new stuff there is. Does any of these look like food? Dwarven Hagler. Let's take it. I like it. It doesn't look like food. Oh my god. Resources. Do I go for gain? Any soothsayer is great. Precision for the silver deer. Oh, that switches resources around, right? The old maiden, maybe? Equipment. Fight Empire? Should I be prepared to fight against empires and then. Maybe resources gain gold. I'm really unsure. Well, you know what? I'm just gonna take another new one. New is always good. Let's take the holy relic. So we got loads of new stuff. Equipment we need. Oh, that's a new one. We don't know what it does, sadly. Colbion sword. We need to kill 50 northerners. Almost got the dark thirst done. With this item and 12 blessings. That's hard. Let's filter this. Let's go for type. No, combat empire.
Archer's Bane. You like that one, don't you?
I do like that one. Resources, is there anything? General, special. Right, there's curses. Get the curse removal in here. I want to take one of those where I can repost against. Bash cause additional damage to armor, I like it. Can I block attacks? Attacks I want to repost though with my eat less. I like it. Map reveal. I like it. Take type. No, combat against the Empire. We got the one-handed sword, so. Or is there some new weapon still? Peeler. No one-handed weapon, so. That one has a token. I'd like to test some of the new ones. Though I think getting rings is really important, or gambit. Any gambit stuff. Shuffle less. Remove a card from the wheel. Mask of Holy Fortunes. Avoid death. Gambler's Jewel. Grifter's Companion. All of this is actually insane. Special. Armor breaking. Curses. Blessings. Food? What? Oh yeah, right. Again, food. Okay. Let's take this. Resources. Food. Armor of Gluttony. Don't starve. Ring of Food. Let's take this one. So I kind of concentrated on food and gambits. I hope we got enough curse removal, and I don't know what this means. I'm just ready to fight against the Empire. Well, that's the setup phase. Let's do it. I believe we got many new cards to explore.
Preparation will be key to your success.
Some tokens
it is here
to get.
That you separate yourself from your predecessor.
Indeed. I can prepare. There it is. The moon. Big map.
A badly shaped tool will not cut smoothly. It will turn and bite the wielder.
Okay.
That is why I have paid such attention to your forging.
Okay. On the last day of solstice, you pass through the gates of the great city. The scene before you is overwhelming. A melange of architectural styles, exotic smells, and busy, busy people. You have taken counsel with your companions and wrestled with self-doubt. Your path is clear now. The Empire is a force of darkness in this world, bringing nothing but death and destruction. If you are truly a hero, this is the time to prove it. There can be no other end than this one. The Emperor must die. Estrella has organized a covert meeting with the General Flinthallow, an ally from her Empire days. He will tell us the way into the palace, she explains, but only if we prove that we have the backing for such a rebellion. Estrella disappears into the crowds, stating she has some business to attend to. You see the meeting place in the distance. The Church of Fires, a shining marble monument soaring above the crowd and rabble of the city. But first you must explore the districts and get enough support for your cause. An Empire soldier stares at you from across the way. You disappear into the market crowd before he realizes who you are. Patrolling soldiers, okay. Let's do this then.
Death stalks these streets. Your death, my death, and the death of an emperor.
While passing through the city's bustling fish markets, you hear a choking sound followed by a terrified scream. Pushing through the panic crowd, you find a family of fishmongers writhing on the ground beside a toppled wagon. You watch in horror as pustules of corruption spread across their bodies and down their limbs, leaving them grotesque and unrecognizable. Let's fight an Aid of Blight, see the new weapon I got equipped. So, we gotta kill the emperor. I like it. Stories take going further. There's the spiked mace. And oh, there it is again. I'm so ready to smash some faces. A chunk of metal covered with spikes, idly suited from dragon and armored knight. For dragon and armored knight from horseback. Regardless of that, it'll smash about anything.
How did you not get the message? We ought to be next way.
Let's smash about anything. I'm perfectly alright with that. ...25 damage with a starter weapon. That's so ridiculous. Finish him off. I don't think just an aid of corruption can do anything to us. No. I said it and then I got hit for it. That's ridiculous. I was blocking and then I decided to press F and then... There we go. So I was like, nah, they can't hit me and I shouldn't have been able to, but they were able to. I lost some HP. I'm saddened, but I'll heal it up again from just food. You pause to inspect the bodies of the vanquished.
Consider your actions carefully, if you would be worthy.
The crowd watches in distress as you loot the newest victim of the blight. Okay, okay. This might be bad.
Back to the bones. I hope you have learned to be their master.
Maybe I should have kept... I should have probably kept the four. Yeah. 4, 5, and 3 would have been enough. Somebody curses and spits on you. Have you no shame? And we got platinum gain cards have no effect. With the grappled creatures dealt with, you stand to leave and hope that no one recognizes you. That's a very good start though. 4, 5, 6, let's go. That's enough.
A win here.
You can have your curious looks from the crowd, thankful the bustle of the city swallows you up again. Very good, very good.
Every performance is at heart a lie.
Parked in a dust quarter. It is a traveling theater that has seen better days. The motted stage curtains hang tiredly. A pastry ill-looking man named Old Patton appears to be the head of this enterprise. He waves you over. White powder has settled into the wrinkles of his face. His painted lips twist into a knowing grin. I know who you are, he whispers. Look here, I won't tell, he taps his red bulbous nose and wings. If you stand in for my recently and rather inconveniently deceased actor, he points out the ragged baker costume. What happened to him? My baker has been walled into his own home, hasn't he? He's gonna either starve or get eaten by the corrupted. The old man looks positively delighted at this prospect. Look here, I won't tell. Oh, right. That's what he said. Be the baker. The play starts off with a hag knocking on the pantomime door. Oh, baker, I've come for your hand in marriage. The crowd claps and jeers as you plant a kiss on the actress or actor playing the hag. They play the part with spectacular realism. Oh my love, dearest of hearts, I bought you a cake, the hag croaks, removing a petrified cake from the folds of her apron. Okay. The cake tastes... I'm gonna follow through this time, by the way. All the way. The cake tastes of cinnamon and is so stale that you are forced to drag your teeth along its rock-hard surface to scrape some crumbs off. The crowd watches in morbid fascination. Oh my god. Then inexplicably a caged boar is dragged on stage. The hag looks at you expectantly. Before anybody can stop you, open the cage. The boar starts before charging off the stage to the screaming crowd. It just scorches your leg as it marks its escape. Maybe releasing a boar to the crowd is a bad idea. The boar gores an innocent bystander before disappearing with a snort down the alley. Other than the person bleeding out, the crowd assumes this is all part of the show. You see the old pattern? Curtsy. You put on your most endearing expression and curtsy your way to victory. The audience is captivated. More gold. You hope the old pattern is happy with your performance. Oh my, what?
I'm not a vain man. You
oh, this is too fast.
That the game, this game, has
no.
been focused for more years than I can count.
Redrawn from
a certain
man.
Pride regarding its twists and turns.
No, stop, at 20 gold. Oh, 20 gold is good. Okay, the crowd cheers and throws coins into the stage as you bow. You've put on a good show. That was not worth it. I lost so much HP. Old Patton is impressed by your dedication to the role. His charcoal eyes well with tears. No, this is acting. or patent twit pledges.
Fame alone has got you here. Let action carry you forward.
Okay. Your escapades at the pagan Wurgen have increased your notoriety. And he did it. Now let's see the inventory. What does this one do again? No, not this one. I know what this one is. What does this one do? The, an enemy is randomly highlighted. Is killed first, so we now gotta focus the one who's highlighted, okay.
Even in my day, it was rare to stumble upon the creatures of the shades. Rarer still, as the mythical fade once more into the night.
So, this is a token, let's see. Oh, I remember. You find a young woman crying, her child tugging at her skirt. She tells you that her eldest has disappeared after ignoring her warning about the fairy ring. So I jump him, I give him 5 food, so I have a chance at victory. I will immediately track this success to the end and back. There we go. Munches a bread roll. Whatever you do, if you see the fawn, don't believe a word he says. He almost always lies, he says with a mouthful. You walk along a path following the cheerful sound of a pipe instrument. You come up on a fork in the road where the fawn plays his pan flute while clicking his hooves. Oh, I can help you, he asks. You inquire about the missing child. Oh, yes! About yay high, scruffy clothes. Yes, he went that way, he says, pointing to the left. Go right. You tread lightly down the path because the guy said, by the way, because the guy said we should not trust him. You tread lightly down the path and come to a magnificent castle. The drawbridge is lowered, so you walk inside. Many goblins and fairies gather in the queen's court. Upon the throne sits the queen, a cherub with 4 faces and a serpent's tail. The first face is a womanly face, the second belongs to a panther, the third is a face of a goat, and the fourth is of a swan. Now that's a vivid image. The queen opens all her mouths and her voice echoes, "A mere mortal in my court? Why have you come?" You explain you're looking for a missing child. Indeed I am. She looks you up and down and says, "You have nothing I want, but I have no need for this snotty child either. Take him." A small goblin walks out of a chamber holding the hand of a small child. He escorts you and the child to another fairy ring and sends you on your way. I require one blessing for this, okay? You reappear in the meadow. The mother runs toward you, eager to see her child. Her face drops when she sees the small hand you're holding doesn't belong to her child, but that of a squirrel. Shocked, you let go and the scroll races up the nearest tree. The mother begins to bawl and spit curses at you. Okay, I get cursed again. Okay, that's bad. So I needed a blessing for a fairy ring. Got you, gotcha. And food. There's this one again. 6 of blight. We'll get cursed again if we loot, so maybe this time we shouldn't. I mean, we got 2 curses already. That's quite a lot. I don't want to get overly zealous with the curses. Oh, my Malaclips is still out of commission, right? Because I hadn't re-spin the wheel. This time we'll do it flawless, though. I believe. Nothing is gonna stop us. See? It is gonna be flawless. And then there's the last guy. Just smack him around a bit. There we go. We beat them. Maybe I'll just leave this time. I'll leave quietly. With the corrupted creatures dealt with, you stand to leave and hope that no one recognizes you. 15 again. Okay. Nice. Very nice. Thankfully, the bustle of the city swallows you up again. Another corrupted city. Oh! That's way more. Is the loot gonna be better? Thing is, am I ready to get cursed again, though? That's the big question. Okay, Malaclips. I can see the marked one. What is this? This doesn't seem right. It was like a weird animation bug. This fight's just... smack him. Malaclips is just being support from very far away. Oh, I shouldn't have pressed. Oh, there, my shield was down. Oh, there we go. Now it's down. Button mashing strat still working. And there we go. Did it. Done, did it. I still prefer Sword and Shield for the repost when blocking. But I can see the merits of doing that much damage. Should I search the spoils? I will search for spoils. No. At least 5 food, very good. Okay. Oh, right, I could have searched for spoils and just rolled a 12. 12 should be very doable. Oh, that was close. With the grub the creatures dealt with, you stand. Okay. So I can loot. I should have looted the other one then. I think 12. 12 is a bit above average, right? It's like 10.5 is average. With 3 dice, because 3.5 is average for a dice. Okay, this time I get recognized. The grizzled bone settler croaks and points wordly in recognition. That it's a traitor, the traitor, Emperor Murder. You press your way through the crowd, you hear somebody yelling for guards. One brimstone monster card? Thankfully. Okay.
So much military attention. And why? Because the Emperor knows you are coming. He has known long before.
A group of soldiers are scrutinizing the crowd in the flower market. Shoppers nervously make their purchases. Stay inconspicuous and pass through. You hope they don't recognize you. That's a success. You keep your head down and continue on your way. Very good. There's another corrupted city. So, I'm fighting against so many corrupted. Could have used the one starter weapon. Was it a starter weapon with a quest for killing corrupted? No, it was a normal weapon. Never mind that, guys. I'm just forgetful. This one is the one I want to kill. Got him. Okay, let's do the normal riffraff then. Oh, I should have blocked that. Get him. Malaclips, shoot me again, thank you. And then I'm gonna use this super immediately. And oh, thank you, Malaclips. Stunning them. And then finishing this guy. And then I'm gonna rest Malaclips, because why the hell not? Smash him. Right, and then there we go. Hit him in the hip. So I will go for the loot again. Hope to hit a 12. Good, I'll keep the 5 though. Okay. Okay, there we go. No one recognizes you. That's the 15, that's way harder. I'll keep the 5, because I need to roll 5 3 times. For each 6 I can roll a 4. That's what I thought. Yeah, found some fame, another brimstone monster card. Okay. Holy relic. That is a new
challenge before you starve to death. Time will tell.
Dude, he's so happy about it. What used to be a lavish monastery has taken a major hit from a recent raid. The monk laments. It's a shame about the missing gold, but it's even greater tragedy that they've stolen our holy relic. You volunteer to search for the raider. Finally, a profitable venture, says Malaclips as he gathers a handful of coins strewn over the ground. Completing raiders. Okay, nice. Okay. You follow a trail of abandoned trinkets to find as a frost berserker sleeping on top of a pile of treasures in a conspicuous forest clearing. Stealthy approach. I was thinking about just smashing faces. You stealthily retie the raiders up without disturbing their slumber and hold the stolen items back to the monastery. The monks grab the carved sapphire head from you as soon as you return. The holy relic, this is worth far more than gold to us, so please take the rest as your reward. Okay. Okay. You know what? I'm so filthy rich. I'm gonna trade and buy whatever equipment there is. Oh. Immediately bought. And then I'm gonna buy some food as well. And that's fine. And then finish trading and break camp. That's the Dwarven Haggler.
Been purged by the Empire in the same way as other races. Frankly, they're too boring.
Oh my god, this guy. Your wanderings led you to a dwarf weighted down with bags, sacks, and other knickknacks. Let's trade, he suggests. I'm sure we can come to a mutually beneficial agreement. Do you have anything for trade? I'll trade for an angel's feather. A rare item indeed, but I do happen to have one. What would you be willing to trade for such a treasure? You can have my feather. It's fine and good, but not a patch on an angel's feather. You begin negotiations. There's the success. I managed to follow it. Alright, you convinced me. Let's trade. You gain an angel's feather. Okay, so I need the horn, the feather. And the third one, and then I can use my ring to do something.
Checkpoints, as if they keep one step ahead of the deaths that hunt them.
At the gates leading to the Blood District, an Empire soldier speaks to a grumbling, slow-moving crowd. It appears there's some sort of hold-up. Join the line. Attention, from this day forward and until further notice, there will be checkpoints at all gates. With the speech over, you continue shuffling through the gates with the rest of the crowd. You hope that you're not recognizable enough to arouse suspicion. It says recognizable, though. Wait, it's back here, right? Yeah. You move along with the crowd, the soldiers manning the gates. A gate, no, just nothing amiss. There's some patrolling soldiers everywhere.
Medicine and chemistry. Places magic can hide as a more specific craft.
The apothecary is inundated with a tense rabble of city inhabitants. As you get closer, you notice that the door has been barred shut. An elderly woman on her knees weeping, clutching a pearl necklace to her chest. Open up, have you no heart? A heavy-set blacksmith pounds on the door. My daughter has succumbed to the rot, his voice cracks, and the rest of the crowd shrinks away from the man, some covering their mouth fearfully. Find another way in. Hopping over a side gate and squeezing past crates, you find the back door of the apothecary. It's unlocked, but a thin, bird-like woman stands by the door, scrutinizing you. Hello, she says with a curt nod. I'm your helm. My twin is Yannis. I have heard that you want to destroy the Empire, and now that I see you are strong of brow and crooked of nose, I believe in your quest. Your helm, the twin, pledges his service to your cause. She bids you goodbye as you enter the apothecary back door. Yannis will want to help you too if you can find her. The owner, a bespectacled, spindly gentleman, jumps at your surprise entrance. Do I lose 50 gold now? Yeah. He considers the heaping pile of gold, then with a sigh pulls a crate out from behind the counter. Inside you see dozens of small bottles of amber liquid. Here, take them. I never claimed this was a cure, but desperate times made desperate people. It is here that you explain your quest, you bespectacled apothecary nods. If you can fix this, yes, I will join your cause. The apothecary pledges a servant. The townfolks outside of the apothecary fall to their knees in gratitude when you hand out the little amber bottles. One bottle is left over, you keep it for yourself. Oh, the widow and the blacksmith. Oh, that was really successful. We got 5 out of 12 now. Stay inconspicuous. Yeah. There's the success. I accept, I tag along with him. There. I'm gonna ignore him. I'm gonna side with the ogre. I'm gonna refuse to fight. Then I'm gonna go for his. Play a guard game. Managed to follow it, nice. Oh, yes, indeed. Perhaps another game, play a dice game. I'll hopefully lose that one so I can play. Actually, maybe I'll lose the manual dexterity on purpose. No, I lose this one, so I'll win the manual dexterity. Perhaps another game? Yep.
The pendulum swings like a scythe, bearing hope or failure.
Perhaps I've got lax. So there's the armor of gluttony. 3 defense if you have 20 plus food. And plus 1 food for every gain card, or this one. Dispels a curse, that's good, but I prefer the food right now because I'm really low on food. I'm gonna starve once.
Gasping with each step, hoping to survive.
I'm not gonna
find food if you can.
Yes, I want to find food in the cemetery.
Many secrets are buried here, and you seem determined to unearth them all.
Only 2 people walk around the grounds today, a weathered gravedigger named Thomas and an old woman in flowered bonnet. The woman introduces herself as Hild and asks you to accompany her to her husband's grave. She pulls you close conspicuously and glares at Thomas. I think they added more stairs. Makes a baffled noise in disagreement. I want to talk to him. The old gravedigger makes his round, clicking his shovel against the ground. I do not care for such things, mercenary, whether it be the Emperor or you or a donkey on the throne, the dead will always be deep burying. Strange going ons. Ooh, a 9? That's easy. He said, and then roll an 8. Oh my god, that was barely a 9. The watcher haunts the cemetery, you know, so I've heard. A demon with 3 eyes. The old gravedigger begins to mumble nursery rhyme. So too the devil, he sought a great disaster he brought to the kingdom company. He'll to Aspen's grave. He'll takes your arm and leads you through a large stone arch towards the tombs. 3 eyes, she says, pointing at a strange symbol of 3 dots etched up on the gate. That's lucky. Really, he said it was a demon. Past graves and flowers you climb until you reach a huge primitive stone tomb fallen mostly to ruin. It is devoid of any markings other than 3 dots bored over the entrance. Ah, here, he'll dusts the wall here. And there with a handkerchief and descends the ancient steps into the tomb. You can barely make out her white dress and crinkled eyes, she beckons you to follow. It's the demon, it's gonna kill me! Something flickers in the passage ahead and the old woman disappears into the darkness. Yeah, I know it's the stupid 3-eyed demon. I just want to see what happens. It's dark and usually warm, you take a tentative step, filling the smooth marble underfoot, the air smells of dust and flowers. Okay, I'm gonna head west. The path leads to a small room with a pile of blankets and pillows set in the corner. A crack in the tomb's roof bathes you in warm sunlight. You're suddenly overcome with exhaustion and want nothing more than to sink to the silk. No, at the blanket part, certainly not. What is east and depth of tomb, you're overcome by a feeling of dread. There's a scuttling sound behind you and your head swims. Lose 1 gold every time you starve. You're at the cursed crossway. West is back at south. There's a chest in here, rustled around the hinges set upon a large stone pedestal. Oh, thank you very much. And one food. Ooh, thank you very much. And one food. And gain an equipment. Mask of Holy Fortunes. Yes, very much so. Head north. Yeah, cursed crossway. Now I'm gonna go north. Statue of a rope woman stands in the intersection waiting with you with hollow eyes. Blind statue. South is back, so I'm gonna go. West is where I came from, I'm gonna go east. Small animal bones litter the floor. Yeah, bone hovel. West, head west again. Inner sanctum. A gaping pit lies in the center of the room, swallowing the light. You have made it to the inner sanctum. A 9 again.
Back to the bones.
There we go.
I hope you have learned to be their master.
Without ceremony, the old widow reappears behind you. Why hello, did you get lost? With a wan smile, hilt hands, and a bunch of. And a, hands you a bundle of dried flowers. She nods encouragingly and stands back to watch. Place them next to the hole. Gently place the brittle flowers on the floor next to the pit. The old widow smiles back at you, her wrinkled face wet with tears. Hilt the deceased pledges her service to your cause. From somewhere above ground, Hilt hides a small smile and states that she must stay here a while to pray. Unnerved, you quickly retrace your steps out the tomb. You find the source of the scream. It's none other than the old gravedigger. The watcher, he's here, he babbles, pointing a shaking hand at a mound of honored tombs. Who's the watcher? Three eyes, he'll drink your blood to turn the flood. The old gravedigger taps his forward frantically as if to ward off the watcher. Okay, you rush up the stairs to confront the threat. A hulking mass slides out from behind the mausoleum. The faceless creature towers over you, its three eyes shining brilliantly. Attempt to reason with it. You hear yourself shout and ramble in all the tongues you know. Okay, this is not gonna happen. There's one, so two sixes now. There we go, I can see it. No, I can't. That didn't work. The watcher screeches angrily in response. Its unholy screams assault you from all directions, leaving you dazed and disoriented. After every combat with you, use the weapon ability or artifact, okay? You quickly consider your options. Fight the watcher. Your weapon passes through the body, and if it were made of air. Another 18? How am I... Okay. That's terrible. It is impossible. And I'm gonna get hurt a lot. Call for help. Your voice cracks as you call for help. That's another 18. So I just need to do an 18 actually for all three options. That's ridiculous. What it's gonna do now? Another 18! Oh no! What the hell? How am I supposed to get an 18 without any... Yeah, that's more life pain. With a keening wail, the creature rears its head back and charges you. More damage. Without warning, you are enveloped in darkness. You drift numbly out of consciousness and awake groggily in a different part of the cemetery. And Thomas is nowhere to be seen. You know what? I'm gonna camp now. I'm gonna trade. I'm gonna buy equipment. That's the new one. Perform a powerful strike that causes knockdown on a single target. Costs while the weapon charge is full. That's really good. That's actually great. But it's not worth it. What I'm gonna do is buy some food. Yes, more food. Two food for six is actually worth it. Finish trading. I'm gonna cook some food. Break camp. Okay. So, there's the soothsayer. Yes. Let's see what the quest would do. Lose three food. Lose all my food. Lose even more food. Lose five gold. Gain an equipment. Gain an equipment. Gain life. Gain life. So I'm gonna lose all my food and most of the gold. But I'm gonna gain two equipments and heal up to full. So I'm gonna lose some gold, right? I'm gonna buy it back again. Get up to a bad start. Bands of brigands as they raid an apple orchard looking thin and wrecked. They're back for food. I give him some. Yeah. A wandering devil disguised as a peasant turns you into a donkey to compliment his disguise. Eventually you're released. I need to go back. That's unfortunate. I'm losing my way to get lost in the forest. You realize the bag you made earlier must have picked some gold.
Be careful now.
Yeah, and then gain an equipment. Oh yes, give me the gambler's jewel. You're wondering, there's the second equipment gain. Draw one food gain card after any combat which you take. Every third step does not consume food and shield reflect. I wanted to use that one and equip it, and now I can deflect with my shield. So I can try to get the Archer's Bane, the token. I gain health, and then the next health is again. Yeah. The mage has left town for an infant without payment. Unfortunate, but okay, so camp. Trade. Oh, food is gone. And the jousting armor, you know what? Optionally retry any precision gambit with increased difficulty. Gain more fame. Okay. That's unfortunate. I thought I could maybe. That's good. That's better than good. That's incredible.
That's incredible!
Oh, because I don't have food and Wetland Ambush give me food after I get ambushed. And the Vigilant Aegis just protected me from consuming food because it was the third step apparently. Though it's very convenient because I got a curse that makes me lose gold when I starve, and I don't want to starve. Also doubles the pain, right? I got the double pain card curse as well. Alright, I can't actually block those. There's the Archer's Bane. No! That's bad. Those corrupted where I can't dodge. Use the finisher, use the special move. And then finish him. Archer's Bane is so good, it attacks fast. I could counter with it if I meet enemies I can actually counter against. Maybe against the Corrupted I should keep the two-handed weapon. Search for supplies, yes, get me food, and then some more of the armor. That's worth it. Patrolling soldiers. Inconspicuous. Mask of Folly Forces, thank you. That's a success. Let's go. Goblin Retainer, that's a new one as well.
You're the sort of person to put their faith in goblins, or merely the sort to give their actions no thought.
Wow. Get roasted. Oh, I'm getting roasted right now. The tower is in chaos, alarm bells have with the garrison soldiers in a panic as you watch a goblin with a hefty sack leaps from a window, dangling from a makeshift rope. Okay. He bounces painfully off the wall, and as he lowers himself to the ground, the castle doors fly open, guards assemble armed and angered. The goblin blows his horn, discharges a little more than a feeble hiss. I need a moment to recharge this, help me, and I'll spit my take-ins. Before you can reply, he throws you an item from his sack. Here's a retainer, he said. Okay. The guards rush forward. Arrest him, they're with the goblin. I don't even get a choice. I'm just gonna get attacked. It's not gonna be good for you, guards. There's muskets. Oh, I can reflect with my, for my... Oh, okay. I got a plan. That's really good. No, I wanted to block the attack. Oh. That's so stupid. I don't know, maybe I should not kill the guards? Oh my god, why am I so bad? I'm not gonna just stand and watch while I try to farm the attack. I'm just gonna fight this out.
I blocked a few shots though, so it's going well, it's going well.
With the goblin gun you make your own escape. Okay, I got some gold. Yes, I'm the one who ruined Napoleon's fun yesterday. How delightful did he cry? Why have six fingers? Okay, so right. I lose one curse for every six. That's a 10, that's really bad. Let's go for at least a 12. That's a 16. It's close, but I lose two curses. Oh, what a roll. I can release you of two curses. What curse will you give me? A plague, perhaps? They taste exquisite. What was this one? Platinum cards have no effect. Lose one blessing. You can have those. You can feel a pull on your soul as the demon wrenches the curses from you. He smiles at your discomfort. Still laughing about Apollyon's failure, the woman waves goodbye and disappears into the night. Yeah, Apollyon, you couldn't get me. I was too good.
The Beast District. What irony.
You join the grumbling citizens and merchants and hope that you're not spotted. I actually get the failure. Hey there, right there! A crude drawing of a face gestures wildly as his comrades press through the crowds towards you. No, I got spotted. That's not good. I hope to be inconspicuous. I had a two-thirds chance not to be spotted, even if I could pick completely random, and I thought I managed to trace it. This is gonna be annoying. And I didn't even manage to. Leave Malaclips alone? Back to me, Malaclips. Actually, shield me as well. I got distracted, that's why I got hit. Got the block in. That's a bit unfair, don't you think? And there we go. Could have rested Malaclips as well while in the animation. I think I've said it before, but I'll say it again. One-handed shield is good against Northerners, and this one does bonus damage against Empire, so it's great. Step over the bodies and press on. I'm infamous now. No. Some more patrolling soldiers. I'm pretty sure it's gonna be way harder every time. Yeah, it is harder. I think that's the... No, that's a failure. No. No, this is... Now this is going downhill very, very, very fast. Yes, now that I'm infamous, maybe it's gonna get worse and I'm only gonna have failures and I can't escape the patrols and I gotta slaughter myself through everything and it feels like it might cost me the gold. Yeah.
Oh, I didn't manage to get out of the way.
Wow! I just threw him down there. Okay, Malaclips, you're gonna get rest now. And then you're gonna shield me. No, I'm gonna leave those behind. General, get away! Okay, there's the general gone. Get him through the block. Okay, now it's only ranged ones. Very good. That's where I can repose and get some more stuff for my token, maybe, with the Archer's Bane. Though I can't imagine any actually a weapon getting better than this. Nonlockers are horrified by the casual display of violence. I'm infamous. Oh, there's the little devil. Give him a curse. Attempt to steal his horn. I could steal his horn for the ring. Ooh, that's hard. There we go.
That will set you in good stead from here.
Devil leaps in surprise, but you land a convincing blow on his head, sending it to the ground in a heap. Soon you effect the horn from its head, you depart before it wakes. Damn, I'm stealing
horns
for everyone.
They hope wolves can keep the sickness away, yet the sickness is in the land itself.
You arrive at a walled-off section in the city. The makeshift barriers are taller than 3 men. Somebody bangs on the wall from the other side, startling you. A desperate wailing pierces through. Maker, please let us out! The passerby are pointedly ignoring the walls and screams. Only a lonely man kneels against the barrier, hand in his head, sweeping. The man notices you approach and trips over himself. Golden hair, short, she always wears a yellow scarf. My Lena, please, please get out of there. You ever... What? I want to help as many as possible for the to get the conspirators. With a running leap, you mantle the makeshift barrier. You land in a burrow much like the others, except it's certain there's a body at your feet. The body does not wear a yellow scarf. Its poor soul is not Lena. There's a groaning noise coming from somewhere ahead of you. In the center of the burrow squats a pulsating mass of corruption, crystallized growth spout from its surface, inside affected horrorous gesture. With a shudder, the crystal cracks apart and the infected creatures emerge with their cocoons to defend the cluster. Okay. I was like, okay, the fight against the corrupted is fine. Oh, there's a spy as well. Oh, this is going downhill fast. I can't manage to seem to be able to handle the spires. Okay, so... Nope, I'm gonna dodge this one, and then it's gonna return. I'm gonna dodge it again, and then I'm gonna hack onto the spire. Get him! Dodge! And then get the spire again, and then dodge, and then... No, that's not the one I want to hack. Also, dodge this one, and then dodge the return. And then special attack the spire. No, that's not the spire! What's going on? Leave me alone! Okay, listen here. Listen here, boys. Please, Malaclips, get rest. No, dodge the entrance and the return. Malaclips, shield me again. Oh, I'm still shielded. Okay, so now I got some room. I can actually... Spire's almost dead. Okay, it's dead. Very good. Now I can handle all the rest of the riffraff. Nope, finish you off. And I finish the next one off. No, I'm
not gonna get hit by that. That's the finishing move. Got the one's armor. I don't think I need Malaclips. I was about to go rest him, but it seems like it's too far away. And I still got his protection. And this seems to be going quite well on my own. Got him. Got him. And then finish him. I managed to get hit there and proc the shield, Malaclips' shield, but other than that, it was fine. I still need lots of food. I will get to Malaclips' at some point, his quest, and I don't have even remotely enough food. The mass of corruption quivers and erupts, spilling black ooze across the cobblestones. As the dust settles, you notice a crowd of townsfolk staring in astonishment from a nearby house. You approach the ragged bunch. Among them, you spy a golden-haired woman with a dirty yellow scarf. You tell her of the weeping man. She pulls you close and whispers desperately, "If you have a way out, please let me get out of here." She looks guiltily towards the others. You must leave them. A group this size will attract too much attention. Lena, the ball maiden, pledges her service to your cause. You hear the happy bustle of the city just over the barricade, but the mood is decidedly more apocalyptic on this side of the wall. A crowd pecks at the body covered with festering, corrupting bones. I'll explore it. You wander the streets of the Forsaken Borough, past bodies in Bordeaux. The stillness is disquieting. Oh, what is going on? Ooh, that was really close, but I did it. I'm kind of proud. Through the dusty window of a tailor shop, you spy a tweedly little man with anxious eyes. You gesture comfortingly, and the man scurries to join you. The silversmith pledges his service. Let's explore it again. The stillness is disquieting. Okay, can I do it again? I can do it again.
Nicely timed.
Indeed. Most of the buildings in this desecrated neighborhood are nailed shut. You are surprised to stumble upon an abandoned schoolhouse with doors wide open. In its small place... It's a small place. Chairs are knocked over, books strewn into the floor, and if its occupant exited hastily. In the gloom you hear the tinkling laughter of a child. Instinctively you unsheathe your weapon, but the room is empty. Loot for supplies? Supplies? How? That's really hard. Oh my god, I cannot believe it actually happened. A glint from behind an upturned desk catches your eye. It's a small glass bottle filled with amber liquid. The yellowing label reads, "Corruption abate, take with all the water." You pocket the cure. Find the source of the laughter. You search the darkened corners of the schoolhouse and unearth a hole in the wall hidden behind the fallen desk. The giggles are coming from somewhere within. You lean to get a closer look. No! It's this again! Oh, I could have done it over there. Instead, I'm gonna do it at one of these really, really horrible points. That's a failure.
Even when things appear impossible, they can be mastered.
You peer through the darkness, keep the practicing. Tiny animal walks uncharacterizably by the corruption, leaps out at you. The mad little bundle of scabs and fur hisses at you and scurries out the door. You pick through the creature's nest but find nothing of value. God damn it, it could have been better. You run straight into a thin, bird-like woman standing at the way of the door. "Hello," she nods curtly. "I'm Yannis. My twin is Yorhelm. I've heard that you want to destroy the Empire, and now that I see you are crooked of brow and strong of nose, I believe on your quest." Yeah, no one said strong of brow and crooked of nose. Nice. Yannis wanders off into the burrow. You ask her if she needs help escaping, but she merely waves her hand and smiles. You hear the happy bustle of the city escape the burrow. Sneak Lena and Farron over the wall. What? The investigation is interrupted by a blood-curdling stream. You turn in time to observe a corrupted creature gnawing at out a man's throat. Fight the corrupted. It's a blight of Juggernaut of blight. I have no idea how to do. You point out the wall in the distance and tell Yana and Farron to hurry. The corrupted are swarming in this area. You must finish them off and get back to Lena and Farron before it's too late. So that's a Juggernaut of blight. The first time we fight against one of those, I think. At least I can't remember ever fighting against them. Oh my god, this quest is so long. I still have so much time. to go, and it the video's ages already. Corruption layered on top of corruption, and nightmare made of sickness and the youth. Just bash to break the terror's armor and defeat them with finisher before it regenerates. I think we might have fought against them actually. No. Stop regenerating. So actually it's just the Terror of Blight, but only way more layers. Finish him off second time. He's gonna regen. Use the special to dodge his attack. No, not this time, but next time I'll do it. Dodge him. Okay, so in a one-on-one fight, that was incredibly easy. The Abomination, a Juggernaut of Blight. So we fought against that at one mission. I can remember fighting against an enemy like this. You rush back to Lena and Farron. They are in the middle of pulling themselves over the wall and using a combination of footholds and piled debris. You push them over, and before it's too late, you climb down the wall and gust from onlookers and hear an astonished cry of joy as Lena and her beloved are reunited. Tolan the Weaver. Farron bids you a nervous farewell and reaffirms his pledge to your cause before hurrying away into the city, glancing nervously around the townsfolk. As you push past the Whispering Crown and disappear into the city, you know that your actions here will place the animal closer to your tail, the Emperor. Yes.
You have far more pride than a usurper ever did, but you reach far further than he did. Curious.
A noxious smell alerts you to an oncoming group of Toshers. I don't actually know what Toshers are. I have to confirm my ignorance. Led by a short, stumpy woman with an eye patch. Eye patch Eve, they call her, and although she dresses in greasy drapes, her fingers are adorned with exquisite rings and their pockets are deep with gold. Look at this princess. I bet they've never done a day's dirty work, she sniggers. What do you say, fancy ecking out a bit of coin? Tides are coming. Better get in there quick, princess, says Eye Patch Eve as one of her consorts lifts a little lid of a manhole. As you and the Toshers come splashing down and your boots soak up the mark, you feel something at the bottom of the putrid subterranean river. Okay. I think I'll take the... Let's draw a food gain card. After combat, the first enemy gains me life. That's a great one. I'll take the visage. You plunge your hands into the rancid water, pull out. Okay. No. You don't understand. I don't need ones and twos. I don't need twos and twos! No! Okay, something bad's gonna happen. You plunge. Yeah, and deep into the repulsive muck onto the fish out of an old boot. I'll have that, snaps Eye Patch Eve. She takes a big whiff of it before stashing it in a crusty bag. The sewer walls tremble, time to surface. Okay. So I didn't get the item. I can though. Okay, interesting. Wait a second. Okay, that's bad. Patrolling soldiers. I'm gonna pass through. Still that one. Oh, I'm a god. You keep your head down and continue your way. Indeed I do. So when I fail, I can't do it again. Buy equipment. Let's see. Ward of the Innocent. Reveal two random encounter cards at the start of each map. Four for two food is really good. Now getting the cheap. Oh yes, give me even more cheap ones. Oh, 4 for 2 food. That's the bargain bin price I want. Get maximum value out of the body armor. Yes, even more so. give me all the food. I'm gonna just buy as long as possible because I know I need lots of food for Malaclipse's quest skill still. One food. As long as there's one food left, I'm gonna get more. Because four gold for two food seems like incredible value. And one last one. There we go. I'm not gonna starve now. Sell equipment. Is there any equipment I can sell? I could get rid of the spike mace and get one more food. Okay, 25 should be enough for my purposes. Leave. Thank you very much. There's the corrupted city again. Fighting against some corruption. Terror of Blight and Affliction of Blight. I can do that. And then I think I'll just leave them be. I feel like my equipment is great. I got the two really good rings. The platinum one for the spinning wheel and the dice ring. I got a sword shield combination I like. I got a useful helmet with all these patrols going on. Makes my odds less awful. Okay, so oh, I should have used my special again to dodge this attack. There we go. Like this. Okay. And then finish him off. Yeah, I need that. Okay, that's one. Good on. Oh, let's get the small fry again. That's one more small fry. The last corrupted. Oh, that's not the last of the small fry, but shouldn't have used his shield again. I'm not gonna shield that. Small fry. Get dusted. Big one. Get dusted. I dodged too early. It was almost a good fight, but then I dodged too early so he could readjust his attack and hit me still. It's unfortunate. Corrupted city. I'm gonna leave quietly. Oh, I should have searched. Why would they do it? I even have the gambler's jewel. I can't just search for spoils. I just need to roll a 10. Okay, I've managed to leave quietly though. Yep. More corrupted city. This time I'll not get cursed. That's Affliction of Blight and Seven of Blight, none of the terror ones, no bashing, just killing them. Better that way, I'd say. Okay. Malakid, shield me, thank you very much. Okay, and there goes the shield. That's what happens when you're bad. Why am I even saving my super? Get the counter in, yes please. Oh my god, that's bad. Malaclipse, shield me! Counterattack. Gotta concentrate. Hit them with the finisher. dodge. I didn't manage to rest Malaclips, but it should be fine. Yeah, there we go. This guy was basically dead. Okay, so this fighting is fine. It's going okay. I'm gonna search for spurs this time, like I said. Jousting armor.
Terribly impractical, but not on horseback. But you will make your own choices.
Complete strength with this. So, I'm not gonna equip it because my the armor right, I get right now is so much food. Okay. You can watch under distress. I don't care. I can roll a 14. No one is gonna curse me. Oh, but then I'm gonna misroll these ones. Okay, so high rolls. That's not a high roll. I'm gonna get spotted. There's gonna be another Brimstone monster card. It's a captain. It's a captain, okay, so. The last patrolling soldiers. I really don't want to fight against the Brimstone cap. So let's get this card. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh. Whoa. To be honest, after the second shuffle, I lost it. I wasn't unsure where it was at the third one.
The moon reaches its height above the city. And upon what does it cast its light? Upon death, destruction, and pain. End this.
Okay, I want to get the two other conspirators, so...
I have been beyond these realms, these pathways through the shadows. You do not understand them.
I get undisciplined, lone wolf, that's three curses to... No. I'll take the long way around. I'll lose some food. Come on, conspirators! No, that's the underneath!
Here is your reward. At least in potential.
So I failed two of those. Probably the two things I failed, yeah. Following Malaclips' cryptic directions, many wishing wolf burrowing farm animals, you arrive at the edge. Yeah. It's so long, I'm gonna read it again. We must seek out Ira of the Vale in the underneath, the bard had explained, as you followed a frightened cow around the previous night. Malaclips drops his wine bottle nervously and falls a loud and hearty laugh. Completely ignoring your question, okay? The respectable ogre manning the door at the underneath doesn't look up from his book as you approach. 10 food per item per entry, he grunts. Robbery, you're trying to hustle us, sir. I'll have you know that I can shoot lightning from my fingertips. Times are hard for us, Mal. You'll see when you get there. Give 10 food. The ogre places his book down and with a mighty push the stone door rolls open. The narrow tunnel takes you deep below the earth, opening into a vast limestone cavern. Trickling on the edge of the underground lake lies a small shanty town, red lanterns lining the quiet streets. Malaclips leads on, welcome to the underneath, coin slave. Since that bothersome empire edict, we've had to hide away in places like this. This used to be quite the hub of activity, but now, he surveys the silent streets grimly, I guess the empire is increasing its forces. A few mages eye you suspiciously as they pass by. Peruse the stores. Oddments, used stone, directions. Malaclips sniffs and backs away. I'm not allowed in there after I stole all the stupid pebbles. He lets you go on ahead. Used stones. Buy a stone that Lilo recommends. Inquire about something else. Directions. Nearest trader, nearest fight. Inquire about something else. Return to the town center. Should it go to the tavern or find his contact? Let's find his contact. Let's just go for it. Malaclips leads the way through the dim, lonely streets to Ira's house. You can hear screaming coming from within. A woman in robes adorned with silver ornament greets you at the door. Merc said you would come begging for help regardless. You're late. Malaclips bows with a grin. I have an illness. I'm hoping to purchase a cure. Ira of the Vale frowns for a bit before nodding and letting you into her house. You enter a sitting room and the source of the wailing is made clear. A man is locked in a cage, crying in fevered agony, sorts of corruption fester on his body. Without warning, she opens the cage and the man rushes at you, but with surprising strength. Ira subdues the mad, writhing creature. This is the mage Cohen. He thought he could fight off the corruption, but he could not. Ira watches Malaclips carefully as Cohen's cries get more and more guttural. What should I do with him? The bard looks away, disgust and fear on his face. He appears close to passing out. She nods before turning to you. What will we do?
Kill him.
With that dealt with, Ira begins tinkering at the table strewn with dead and shiny things. I do have a cure, but as you know, nothing comes free with our kind. She taps silver dust from a bottle. Save the stolen mage children for me and I will give you the cure.
A reward well earned.
Those Empire bastards have taken them to some walled fort in the docks of the city. And you better hurry, Ira smiles at Malaclips. Their illness can't be held at bay for much longer, I'd wager. The bard avoids her gaze. He hasn't told you? Then it's not my place to say, but know this, friend of Malaclips. If he doesn't find a cure soon, you're in grave danger. Nonsense, he says. Okay. How do you know? He was my lover when I was young and stupid, Ira says, matter-of-factly. Nonsense, Malaclips shouts. Why, I'm alluring at all ages. You'd be glad to have me still. Ira gives Malaclips a severe look and he barks, cowering in his seat. Okay. Let's enter the Devil's Tavern. Malaclips breathes in the heady scent of berry wine, smoke and feathers. Ah, the Devil's Ears, my home away from home. He pulls out his lute and leaves to serenade the pretty bartender. She tries her best to ignore him. A decrepit hag nurses a smoldering pint glass at one end of the bar. Alone in the corner, hooded figure lurks unmoving. Okay, you cannot discern any facial features under the heavy hood. The figure nods at you. He has a grave voice whispering, quiet and hoarse. I seek an artifact of great power, something that will twist the minds of my enemies and force them to fight for me. I will pay handsomely. You have nothing to trade. Okay, approach the hag. The water cone sips her drink and smells strongly of citrus and burning coal. While sizing you up, you wish to buy something, do you not? She grins wickedly, revealing a mouthful of jagged yellow teeth. I can send you somewhere, no cost, but I cannot assure that you will end where you want. Ask what she's drinking. That cackles. This is a pint of liquid plague. I'll let you take a sip, but I'm reasonably certain it would be the last thing you ever did. No, don't teleport me. Return to the town center and leave the underneath. Mal, the bard turns around. You catch a glimpse of hope in his eyes. She avoids his gaze. Take the children to the madman near Forcefront. They run an orphanage. I fear it is no longer safe here. Okay, guys. So, I'm disappointed. We didn't get all the conspirators. It's night by the time you arrive at the Church of Fires. Estrella's army awaits within a hushed marble cathedral. Through the flickering candlelight, you walk past row upon row of wooden pews to the front of the temple. Beyond the altar, you climb a moonlit staircase until you reach the vast doors leading to the West Terrace. You heave open the heavy doors. An Empire general with grey hair and a kindly face greets you. Ah, you must be the traitor. Your face is plastered all over the city. Are you incredibly sly or incredibly ruthless? General Flinthallow, at your service. General Flinthallow reviews the blood pledges to your cause. You insult me, he frowns. Without the people's support, you're nothing but a common assassin. And
surely I have trained you better than this. Focus.
Before you, a Malaclips can react. General Flinthallow draws his pistol with lightning speed and shoots you in the neck. Okay, still alive, eh? Maybe you have gumption and heart enough to after all. The general stands over you as blood drips into your cupped hand. But I can't allow you to leave here, I'm sorry. Then, with a whistle, a troop of soldiers fills the church terrace. They are accompanied by an ogre. The ogre's arms are locked in heavy shackles and the Empire sigil is branded on its back. The soldiers release the chains and the ogre shudders, its yellowed eyes darting around wildly. Some unknown condition prevents it from trying to escape. Slavery? Did you lot run out of ideas on how to be evil? Malaclips draws out his book of spells. You draw your weapon. Okay. I am very disappointed with... Like, I failed the one at the laughing with the children where nothing happened. I probably could have saved someone over there. And then... I must have felt something else, but this episode took so long, I really actually can't remember. And that's a bit disappointing. What iron will could break and enslave an ogre? The ogre's thick hide. Yeah, I know. Okay, you know what, ogre? I'm gonna leave you be and gonna kill the general first. Mr. General Man, this is not gonna end well for you. Oh, I didn't want to attack the ogre. No, Mr. General Man. And it ended well for him. Oh, that's terrible. Okay. We got the ogre. Oh no, I could have blocked that one. I thought I could maybe dodge it. Am I gonna die now at the very end? You know what? I'm not gonna die. I just told myself that I'm not gonna die. Malaclips, shield me again! No, Malaclips, shield me! Yes, okay. I know the ogre dance of block, block, dodge, and then hit him a few times. Block, hit him, block, hit him, dodge, and then get him done. There goes the chained ogre. Now it's only the musket men. And we did it. It was close and it's only silver. I'm very disappointed, but that's what I thought after we messed up the challenge. When was the first one? When was the first companion we failed? Oh, but the Archer's Bane token. Very nice. Very nice indeed. General Flint Hello lies dying in a pool of his own blood. You have bested me. He draws a choking breath and his eyes fall on the dead enslaved ogre. Listen, listen. The land is sick. Maybe you are right. Maybe the Emperor must die for it to heal. You must be vigilant. They know you are here now and they know you are coming for him. As the last breath leaves his body, the general looks at you appraisingly, blood welling in one eye. You will die in there, you know. Okay, so we beat it, but not very good.
It will come for the Emperor, and we will see what changes.
Hunter's Blade, Dead King Scales, and Brigand's Shield. So what else did we do? We did Malaclipses, for convincing Ira to help Malaclips, the stolen ones. And for persecuting ranged enemies with the Archer's Bane, we get the Dazzling Blade. So, that's another silver token.
The sun unfolds. 5 gates stand before us. 8 lie at our heels. Can you feel the power that lives in this place? It is close now.
All companions who cried to play this challenge? No! Corbion is dead! Okay, so, this might be a problem. So, what we're gonna do is, justice is against Northerners. And I need Corbion to get Corbion's sword and fight against Northerners. So what we're gonna do the next episode is probably do the Hero Fund again. It should be very fast and pretty easy. Just so I can complete it and not feel like total crap. Then we'll do justice again and hopefully get Corbion back. And then I don't know if I'm gonna do the moon again and or continue on, but I just want to clean this up a bit. But at least we managed to beat the moon. We got some new cards. I hope you had fun watching. At least as much as I had fun playing. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next episode.